After losing Giancarlo Stanton to a season-ending groin injury over the weekend, the Marlins are looking at the recently released Alex Rodriguez to fill the sudden void in their lineup. In fact, ESPN's Jim Bowden says A-Rod will join the Marlins as soon as he clears release waivers Monday. At jimbowden_e.s.p.n, A-Rod to the #Marlins is going to happen. Has to clear waivers Monday, but it's going to happen. Play 1B, MLB Network Radio, at Loop Network Radio, August 15, 2016. John Heyman of Today's Knuckleball says Rodriguez joining the Marlins is not necessarily set in stone, but the team, specifically owner Jeffrey Loria, has keen interest in signing him. From Heyman, Marlins owner Jeffrey Loria is said to have a keen interest in free agent Alex Rodriguez. But while Loria is of course involved in baseball operations, it is still less than a certainty A-Rod will play for his hometown team. Loria is said to have let manager Don Mattingly and the baseball people do their thing this season. Exhibit A was Ichiro playing and getting his 3,000th hit in Colorado rather than waiting one day to do it on a homestand, and it remains uncertain how likely a Marlins, A-Rod marriage is. Once Rodriguez clears release waivers, that will absolutely happen. Any team that claims him would have to absorb the $25 million or so left on his contract. Any team will be able to sign him for the pre-rated portion of the league minimum. That works out to about $135,000 or so the rest of the season. Even with that friendly financial situation, the Marlins have a history of signing release veterans for the pro-rated minimum, Edwin Jackson, Chris Johnson, etc. A-Rod seems like a poor fit for the Marlins because he hasn't hit at all this season. The Yankees released Rodriguez last week simply because he is no longer productive. He hit .200/.247/.351, 59 OPS plus, in 65 games and was mostly glued to the bench in the second half. A designated hitter who can't hit is a dead roster spot. The Yankees decided they were better off playing A-Rod all that money to not be on the roster, but the Marlins are his hometown team. A-Rod grew up in Miami and still makes his home there, so joining the Marlins would be nice and convenient. He'd be in his own backyard and close to his family, which he says is important to him. Every player wants to play close to home, and this would be Rodriguez's first chance to do so as a big leaguer, but he doesn't like playing first base. There's no DH in the AL, and given his complete immobility at third base, Rodriguez would have to play first with the Marlins. He doesn't like doing that. I haven't touched my third base glove in a long time, but I definitely feel more comfortable there than at first base, he said during his farewell press conference following Friday's game, when he played one out at third base in the ninth inning. A-Rod would have to play first base with the Marlins. Use it see the Marlins are without regular first baseman Justin Bauer. He's on the DL with an ankle sprain and is not particularly close to returning, and lately they've been using Derek Dietrich and Chris Johnson at first. Signing A-Rod would push Dietrich to right field to replace Stanton. Platooning A-Rod and Johnson, two righty hitters, wouldn't work out too well, but it's doable. But he wants to get to 700 home runs. He may not say so publicly, but A-Rod desperately wants to get to 700 home runs. Anyone who's followed him the last few seasons knows that. He's only four homers away from 700. And based on his chats with the media that these last few weeks, Rodriguez had made it pretty clear he still believes he has some quality baseball left in him. Despite those poor numbers this year, A-Rod believes he could get those four home runs by the end of the month if given regular at-bats. That's just the way he's wired. It takes a certain level of confidence to be an elite athlete. The Marlins might be A-Rod's last, only, chance to hit those last four dingers and get to 700 for his career. But he sounded like he was done last week. Both before and after Friday's game, Rodriguez sounded very much like a player who is at peace with his career being over. These last few weeks have been very difficult for him, he called being benched embarrassing, and you could tell he's worn down. Unless it's Yankees owner Hal Steinbrenner, I probably won't be answering the phone for anyone, said Rodriguez on Friday. I said on Sunday that my horizon is Friday, and it still is. After all of this, I'm going to need a long nap so I can recover. I'll see where life takes me, but right now, I value wearing this uniform, and wearing the Yankees pinstripes is enough. Of course, it's tough to take anything Rodriguez says at face value given his history. Retiring in pinstripes sounds like a wonderful idea, but the opportunity to play close to home in Miami while getting a shot at hitting those last four home runs might be too great to pass up. The Marlins and owner Jeffrey Loria are just crazy enough to sign A-Rod, and A-Rod has just enough reasons to keep going,